serve two images of man that have been cherished for centuries. The first is a man as an essentially mysterious being, not fully explicable by his milieu, having at least a small core of unaccountable volition and capable of some spontaneous, unpredicted, unpredictable behavior. At the very least, capable of resisting the combined force of his endowment and his milieu in order to determine his own character, his own self. The second image of man that Skinner takes down, according to Keitel, is that of a being who, rationally comprehending the requirements of the moral law, attains through his own efforts a measure of moral excellence, using his conscience against his temptation, toughened and refined in the process, and therewith granted a full appreciation of what it is good. Having thus focused the question of worth or dignity around the specific matter of moral virtue, Cato replies first to a critique of Skinner leveled by Joseph and others, leveled by Joseph with Crutch in A Measure of Man in 1953. For Keitel, Crutch so succumbs to the allure of the first image of man just described, we can go back on the slide, that of a mysterious being, that he finally chooses ignorance over knowledge, Crutch does, subject to a fondness for being at the mercy of chance or the unknown, which we have already noted in the anti-utopian mentality. According to Keitel, Crutch evades the point that it's only reasonable to see how culture influences the formation of character, and according to Keitel, Crutch simply refuses to try a position where culture would cease to stop working in our despite and behind our backs. With respect to the second image, that of a man as one who achieves moral excellence by volition, Keitel does it.